street because I like stuff. So like I'm a guardian. This is a piece by my friend Aya, who is not able to be here, and she is rather busy with a brand new little baby. And I've seen it form once, which I believe is the only time, this past 12th night. It is inspired by a story about a certain baron who enjoys his cookies. Well, I've served as a retainer, and I've stood just once a guard. And a little bit more recently, I've even sat as bard. And the one thing that I've noted for it needs a little sharing is the flaky leader of our group should be called the Cookie Baron. He needs a cookie, he needs a snack. For the Yeti living on his crown is clawing at the baron. He needs a cookie, he needs a snack. For the Yeti living on his crown is clawing at the back. Now, can we really blame him? No, he keeps a fearsome pet. For a Yeti can be quite scary, especially when wet. And really, there's just one thing that can keep his coat so smooth. To give him heaping amounts of snacks and feed, that's we do. He needs a cookie, he needs a snack. For the Yeti living on his crown is clawing at his back. He needs a cookie, he needs a snack. For the Yeti living on his crown is clawing at his back. Sari is a saint, you see, who does much more than knits. For she has to keep a secret store of delicious chocolate chips, and suffers every single day from lack of good night's sleep. For every couple of hours or so, she hears the Baron's weep. I need a cookie, I need a snack. For the Yeti living on my crown is clawing at my back. I need a cookie, I need a snack. For the Yeti living on my crown is clawing at my back. So before you keep a Yeti safe and warm inside your home, remember our poor Ilya and the challenge of his throne. For without that Yeti, he could munch on different foods. Nah, a cookie is a cookie, and it's just a plastic good. He needs a cookie, he needs a snack. For the Yeti living on his crown is clawing at his back, he needs a cookie, he needs a snack.